Santham Academy. Welcome to Digital Kaksha. To get updates on new videos, click the subscribe button and the bell icon.
Hello students. Today we will study about the phenomena of scattering of light. Scattering of light, it is a phenomena in which the light is redirected in different directions after striking to an obstacle. There are several factors on which the scattering depends, and the utility of these factors we will come to know in the different applications which occur in nature and which can be understood on the basis of the phenomena of scattering of light. Let us come to know the first application for the scattering of light, that is, the color of the sky is blue. When in the spectrum the sequence of the colors is known to us, when we move from the violet color towards the red color, the wavelength, it keeps on increasing. So if we will compare the wavelength of blue with any of the colors on the right side, so blue color has got the less value of the wavelength. Also, the scattering phenomena is inversely proportional to the wavelength of the color. When the sunlight, it travels in the atmosphere, the particles which are small in size and are present in air act as the obstacle for the scattering of the light. So when the sunlight touches these particles, the scattering phenomena takes place. And since the wavelength of the blue color is less, so this color is scattered more as compared to other colors, and for this reason the color of the sky is seen blue in color. Let us come to the next application, that is, the color of the clouds is white. Now all of you know that the clouds, they contain the water droplets. The size of the water droplets is so large that when the sunlight strikes to the water droplets, these water droplets have got the capacity to scatter all the seven colors equally. Now after scattering, the seven colors are seen in the combination of or in the form of the white color. So that is the reason that whenever we see the clouds in the sky, the color of the clouds, it is seen white in color. Now depending upon these factors, one more thing can be explained, that the astronauts, when they are in space, to them the color of the sky, it appears black. The reason is quite simple, as in space there is no obstacle present for the scattering phenomena to take place. That is why the sky appears to them dark in color. For the same reason, when we go high up in the planes, or the travelers who are traveling by plane, so when the plane reaches to the higher altitudes, the color of the sky is seen dark by those passengers, because the scattering phenomena is not very prominent at the higher altitudes. Let us come to the next application, that is, the danger signals are red in color. Now as we have discussed previously, that in the spectrum the wavelength of the red color is maximum. So with the help of this factor, that scattering has got the inverse relationship with the wavelength of the color. Since red color has got the maximum value of the wavelength, for that reason the scattering of the red color is minimum. Now when the scattering of the red color is minimum, so that red color which is used in the danger signals can be seen from a far distance also. So in order to warn the persons for or about any of the danger anywhere, the red color is used in such danger signals. Coming to the fourth application, this also you must have observed during morning time and evening time, that is the sky appears red at the time of sunrise and sunset. So what happens that at the time of the sunrise and the sunset, the position of the sun is near the horizon. In other words, we can say that during these two times, the position of the sun is at a far distance from the earth. So during that time, the light or the sunlight has to travel the maximum distance to reach to the earth. During traveling these large distances, the blue color and the other colors which are present in the spectrum are scattered away. Since the red light has got the maximum wavelength, so the scattering of the red color is the least, and for that reason only the red color is seen in the sky at the time of the sunrise and the sunset, or the color of the sky is seen reddish in color because of the maximum wavelength of the red color and its least scattering. During noontime, the position of the sun is directly over our head. So the sunlight has to travel the less distance during that time. So that is why specifically the sky it appears red at the time of sunrise and sunset. So these are the applications of the phenomena of the scattering of light. After the applications of scattering of light in nature, let us know about what is the meaning of Tyndall effect. Tyndall effect is the phenomena of scattering of light by the colloidal particles. So when the particles which are present in the colloidal solution, the light is allowed to pass through this colloidal solution, it is getting scattered, and this phenomena is only called as the Tyndall effect. The Tyndall effect can also be seen where these are the two examples given. First, when a fine beam of sunlight enters a smoke-filled room through a small hole. At that time, we can observe this effect, to which we are calling as Tyndall effect. Also, when the sunlight passes through a canopy of dense forest. So in these two cases also, the Tyndall effect phenomena can be observed.
Thank you students for watching this video.
Thanks for watching. If you like this video, make sure to like, share and subscribe for more.